Good day everyone and thanks for tuning in to my channel. This video is my suggestions for the maximum punishments for the peacekeeper. By no means am I the authority on being a peacekeeper, so it's very likely that I get something wrong, or maybe you have some better ideas for any punishments. And if you do, then you are very welcome to share it in the comment section below. Even after watching the video, I would still recommend you to check out the comment section, because sometimes people have something to add to my videos. Maybe I got something wrong, then they will all be listed down there. I'll try to highlight and like the best comments so that they get on top so you can see those first. I think this would be a good way for all of us to get better at being a peacekeeper. And with all that said, then let's get into the video. The peacekeeper doesn't actually have that many different kinds of punishes, but that doesn't mean she's easy at all. Some of her punishes can be a little bit long, so that means you have to do a whole string of moves, so it's pretty easy to mess that up. Also, her punishes do seem to deal not so much damage, but that is because she doesn't deal that much raw damage and most of her damage is from bleeding. And accounting for the bleed, she actually has some really impressive damage numbers. A heavy parry lands you a zone attack for 15 damage. You only need to do the first half of the zone attack so you can just cancel out the rest. A light parry grants you a heavy attack follow up by quick light attack. That is a total of 31 damage, 21 raw damage and 10 bleed damage. The bleed damage is 5 ticks of 2 damage over 10 seconds. A guard break. Guardbreak lands you a triple light attack for 6 raw damage and 32 bleed damage. That is 38 damage total. The bleed damage is 8 ticks of 4 damage over 10 seconds. Do note that you do not have a heavy follow-up to a guardbreak. Wall throw. You must be far from the wall for this to work. Stab quickly 2 times, follow up by a throw, then follow up by dash heavy and light attack. That is a total of 45 damage, 20 raw damage and 25 bleed damage. The bleed damage, that's 10 ticks over 14 seconds. The out of stamina throw is the same as the wall throw. That means you do 2 quick stabs, then push, do a sprint forward, heavy attack, light attack, total of 45 damage. 25 of these is bleed damage. It probably should be for more like 46 damage, but it got maybe was a little messed up when I did my example here. Out of stamina parry. You have to see which side the guard is on. Once you parry, you change to the opposite side of the guard, then you do a side heavy followed up by another heavy and a light attack. That is a total of 56 damage, 46 is raw damage, 10 damage is bleed damage. Bleed damage, 5 ticks of 2 damage over 10 seconds. Trying this on a top attack will unfortunately get you blocked. Or parried. Out of stamina parry for top guard. Zone attack, heavy attack, light attack. For a total of 46 damage. The bleed damage, 5 ticks over 10 seconds.
What are you doing?
Special punishes. Peacekeepers have deflect ability. I was able to reliably get guard breaks upon deflects, but I'm not sure if these are guaranteed. What is guaranteed though is a light stab that deals 20 damage and 15 bleed damage, a total of 35 damage. The bleed here is more powerful than other bleeds, so it is 5 ticks of 3 damage for 10 seconds. And I think that pretty much sums it all up. Thank you very much for sticking with me until the end. If you like the video, then you are very welcome to give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see some more, you're also free to maybe subscribe to my channel. That would be pretty cool. So with all that said, then thanks again for watching and see you around.